Hey Matt, so what are you going to explain to us today?
Well, we just did that video on switches, and I explained that a switch is like having two pieces of wire that you join together, and when you join it together, then electricity can flow through it. And it's easy to think that that's all there is to it. So what I've got here is a setup with a few of the switches that we saw earlier. When you press this switch, the LED, and up here on the scope, you can see when I press the switch, the voltage goes low as the LED comes on. When I let go of the switch, the voltage goes high. Okay, so it looks like it's either on or off. But what I wanted to explain was this thing called switch bouncing, which is something that we have to take care of in the keyboard. And I think a good way to explain it is, inside the switch you've got these springy metal contacts. So they're kind of like springy like this. So when you make the connection, you're twisting and letting go of the string. And what's happening if you zoom in there, something like this. So it's not just on or off. As the connection is made, you're getting this bouncing here. So with a fast scope, I can show you that as I press this, I'm gonna zoom in, I'm gonna keep on zooming. And now you can start to see that bouncing happening. So if you've got a microcontroller that's looking at the switches, and it's got a level where it thinks that the switch is on and off round about here, then as you press it, it's going off, on, off, on, off, on, off, on. So for one key press, you've maybe got six or seven presses. So what we have to do in the microcontroller is either ignore those or filter them out or sample repeatedly, and only after it's been on for a long enough time do we then send the signal to the computer. So that is called the debounce delay, and it's the time that you're filtering out all those signals that you don't want to send the computer, because you want to press the key once and have one command being sent. So that's why with mechanical switches you've always got this little bit of delay time where you're debouncing them before you can send it. So I thought it'd be interesting just to have a look at this. Is a linear, and it looks like this. The timescale is 20 microseconds for each one of these divisions. A microsecond is 1 millionth of a second, which sounds like a very short amount of time, but these microcontrollers that are scanning very, very fast as well. So now I'll put in a clicky and have a look at what that looks like. To me, that looks like we're getting a lot more
bounce.
Yeah, a lot more bounce there, especially on the on. If I just change that back to the linear. I think the thing to see from this is how noisy they are. It's definitely not on and off. Look at that one, that's a clicky. Look how noisy that one is. To zoom out. So that's I've changed the timescale, so this is 1 millisecond, so that's only 1/1000th of a second now. And this switch is bouncing for 2/1000ths of a second before it's changed its state to be either on or off. Looks like when you press it, it's worse than when you release it. So that's what switch bounce is, and the reason we've got to get rid of it is because otherwise when you press that switch, if you're scanning your key matrix at say 2,000 times a second, we just saw here that was lasting for 2/1000ths of a second, so you might get two reads there, or three or four reads, depending on the speed of your scanning matrix. So you have to do a bit of debouncing.
Cool. Thank you, Matt.
If you're interested to learn more about the Race keyboard, you can click the subscribe button. Or if you're interested to purchase one of these beauties, you can head over to our website at Dygma.com.